on the island of Newfoundland, upon the Sandwich Coast, lies the little town of Virgil, to whom I'll sing this toast. There are so many highlands that lie just off her shores, and when the cold north wind blows, you can hear the billows roar. The people from the village make their living from the sea. They like their independence, it shows that they are free. Some fish in their small boats, in the wind, the rain and sleet, while others make their living on the offshore, call their fleet. They've known the sheer of tragedies down through the years, and when the memories overcome, they show their grief with tears. For they have lost some loved ones to the furies of the seas, for heartaches and heartbreaks are locked in memories. This village, it's got beauty carved on its rugged shore. 7 miles of pure white sand, who could ask for more? The mountains and the valleys where the rivers run so fast, and the salmon rise to the sportsman's fly as he makes another cast. Now the people of this village love their native home, for anyone who goes away most surely will return. Just like that lifelong mystery, the answer you won't know. What makes this rugged village burn so deeply in your soul? What makes this rugged village burn so deeply in your soul?
Good evening, and welcome to This Week in Review. Tonight in our stories we have Work on Water System, Minimum Requirements for Firefighters, A Rock Wall, Hershey Kiss Roses, Bingo Blotters, Graduation. Please stay tuned for these stories after this.
Dear Children's Wish Foundation of Canada, thank you for sending me Rory the Lion. That means I'm going to get my wish, and that makes me really, really happy. Yesterday he was sad, but I told him, it's okay, Rory, they'll make 2 more needles until my wish. I will send you pictures from the top of the Rocky Mountains. Love, Emily.
Imagine the difference a wish can make. Click on childrenswish.ca and give today.
The contractors have been in working on the water system this week. Wednesday night, they begin to fill up the tank. Some residents woke up to whiter water on Thursday morning. Not all residents received the cleaner water at the same time. Depending on where you live, it took longer for the old water to be drained from the pipes and the cleaner water to replace it. The valve on the cemetery road had a leak and had to be fixed. During this period, the water was put on a bypass and not coming from the tank. While talking with the town manager, I asked about a rumor I had heard where the new system will be only running for 6 months of the year. He did say that this was not correct, but if the residents does not reduce the amount of water, that is being run from January to April, then it will be put back on the bypass and we would end up with the same color water as before. For all those who did not receive the clear water and increased pressure on Thursday, they should see a difference by the end of the weekend. On Tuesday, the firemen attended a seminar on minimum standards. Mr. Everett Pitts presented the seminar. All firemen are required to have the training in order to be a member. All the firemen that are in town attended the training, and only the ones who did not weren't there because of being away due to work. Once they return, they will receive their training by either Deputy Fire Chief Dave Macdonald or Training Officer Ross Ann. Here's a small sample of the presentation that they attended.
As says that a new fire should have the orientation level complete before attending an emergency. Basically, what minimum standards are is your rights, safety of firefighters. It's got nothing to do with actual firefighting itself. There's no other basis. The intent is that a firefighter must be to ensure they can function safely in an emergency. Remember that a firefighter must also be trained for each task that's assigned to them. So if you're a firefighter, new guy, depending on the fire, need something for green apparatus on, somebody asks you about it now, you say, I haven't got that training yet, and you know, not what we're doing. A lot of them can't send somebody into a burning building that they don't know what they're doing. So now you know you can't do that, so therefore you don't do it. This level should provide an acceptable level of training for the firefighters, and not as it to himself, or others at an emergency scene. I'm going too fast, let you know. I'll take with 2 hours. Course outline includes the incident command system, personnel accountability, safety, personal protective equipment, hazard material and transportation, which is probably the driest part of the program, and the workers and regional benefits. So I'm just here on both because we had a firefighter died down in the Sea area, and when he went to check insurance, he found out that the insurance at that time stated that if you had any pre-existing conditions and you died from these conditions, then you wouldn't be covered. And the firefighters said, well, I didn't know about that. Just because I didn't read the letters that came out from government. Because it was written in the letters. So I know I was fire chief at the time and I remember seeing that if you had the pre-existing conditions, you weren't covered, right? So now you know that, which some of these things are taken out with. If you knew that now, and you had a bad heart, and knowing you're not going to cover you, if you die fighting the fire, then you have a choice. You are, be a firefighter and say, I'm going to stay on, take the chances, I'm going to die, I'm going to die. What if I'm getting anything? Or I'm staying home and not be a firefighter and die, still getting anything. So the choice would be yours then, right? But at that time, the family of the guy who died didn't realize that there was no insurance. They all thought there was no insurance. This for the fire service, so the old world nerdy air says to get containers of water, ladders to reach the roof. The Buck Brigade used to put fires, and the Pilgrim brought firefighting methods to nerdy air. And the first volunteer fire department was by Benjamin Franklin. Cities and towns organized fire companies and fire departments. Crews protected cities and towns. And Benjamin Franklin organized one of the first groups, and he also founded the first fire insurance company. Before there was, like in some towns, there were two fire departments. Whichever one arrived on the scene and opened up the hydrants, that's when we got paid for the fire. So what the other fire department would come down and do, before the insurance guy get there, see what the fire is, they would take on, disconnect everybody else's hose and hook up theirs. So when the insurance guy came, the department A had the hose connected, but that's what got paid, even though the department B put the fire. And that's the reason why you spark the fire down to them that day. Cities and towns organized fire companies and fire departments. Groups made up of military organizations and adopted that same rank still or structure. And then after they joined our firefighters and America were volunteers. They evolved into today's fire departments still instilling the military rank structure, so Sergeant Chief, Deputy Chief, Captain, and Lieutenants. Incident command system. You guys have an incident command system. Mr. Deputy Chief, you guys have an incident command system?
Pretty much.
Yeah. Basically what it is, effective manner. The system forms the guidelines that all commanders use to control an incident for safety, efficiency, and accountability.
Mr. Dean Macdonald and his wife Amanda are building a rock wall around his garden and house. I went over to see what he was doing. Dean had learned this craft from his brother Dennis, which does this sort of thing for a living on houses for the very rich. Dean invited me back again in several weeks when more has been completed.
You're putting the mortar in it on now, isn't it? So the rocks come from in over the road, or?
Yeah, rocky ridges.
Okay. How long have you been at this now, Dean?
Week.
Oh, it's fine.
Well, I just had to stomp this air for a couple of days. Because it was raining.
How high do you plan on making that wall?
That's how high it's going. I'm going right in with stone, right?
Oh, okay.
To the house. So I'm going up the wall.
Oh, okay.
Wall. Now, here. I'm going to do my front this year in stone.
I guess that takes a lot of truckload of rock to get that.
Yeah, right. 25 truckloads.
In the rock.
Please stay tuned for more after this. Try your luck on Wednesday and play TV Bingo sponsored by the Cancer Relay Team Daffodils. Cards are 6 for $5 and can be bought from any member of the Daffodil team or in most stores around town. The Butterfly Kisses Relay Team sold some Ursi Kiss roses for Mother's Day. Over 300 roses were made and sold. All proceeds will go towards the Cancer Relay in June. All the names were entered into a draw for a gift basket to be drawn at a later date. Also during the past week, the Lions Club have been selling bingo blotters for Mother's Day. This is a Lions Club initiative and they try to add blotters to fit every occasion. The next lot of blotters available will be for Thanksgiving. As of Thursday, only a few blotters left out of the 140 the day ahead. On Friday, the grade 12 class of Bridge Academy held their graduation. 7 students took part. They were Christopher Buffett, Zachary Clothier, Justin Dominey, Jennifer Drake, Nikita Fudge, Dylan Macdonald, and Joshua Caldwell, a former student, came back to celebrate with them. The evening began with a church service. then continue with supper in Virgil Academy Gym, with Miss Dana Green as MC. Toasts were presented and guest speakers, and then the presentation of scrolls. Dallin Macdonald and Jennifer Drake were the valedictorians.
One of which was pretty funny. He and Vance were driving around one night, late at night, but not after 12, right, Justin?
Nope.
And as they passed the bank, he all of a sudden swerved towards the edge of the road and quickly swerved back into his own lane. The next thing goes, "What was that?" All he said back was, "I thought I saw a bag of money on the road." That explains the spoil of kicking a bag of money in a man knock on the pit. Determined to find a big bag of money, are you, Justin? Anyway, we're going to make some crazy stories. Have fun next year.
Let's get to talk about Donald for a little bit. As you are all anxious to hear what we have to say about him, I'm sure. Well, I'll let you start off by saying that he has been quite the entertainer with his jokes and antics. And it's rarely a dull moment when Dylan's around. Even from the first week or so we came into our lives, we could tell that this kid was going to be funny because he walked into class one day and said a pretty corny joke. What do you call a magician in a spaceship?
A flying sorcerer.
Yeah, it wasn't funny back then either. God, too, because you can only tell so many bad jokes until people just tell you to shut up. Nah, but it's okay. Even I was so obsessed with money a little while back, like all through junior high. We were in class one time when Mr. Vivian was teaching us social studies, and we were kind of bored. When all of a sudden we see Dylan run to the front of the classroom, pick up a quarter, and run back to his seat without Mr. Vivian seeing him. So thinking this would lighten up the mood in the classroom, Brittany Bella decided to start putting small change little nickels and dimes on the ground next to her seat and watch him run up to the front of the classroom again and again picking up this change she was putting in. It went well until she dropped the quarter, and Dylan got really excited about it, ran up as fast as could, and then started his way back. He tripped on his own feet and fell ass first into the back wall, causing a loud thud through the whole school. Mr. Vivian looks back. We all start to laugh and say, "Not even going to ask Dylan." It was pretty funny, I have to say. Let's go back even farther and find something more embarrassing about Dylan. He and I used to date back in grade 5 a few times over. It was going well until one winter, we were out by Mason Valley's house, building snowmen. Dylan had built this one huge snowman that he was really proud of. Then I got the idea to beat it down, and that was the end of our relationship. Me, Mason, and Terry, I beat it down, and Dylan broke up with me for it. So if anyone sees Jessica tonight, tell her to stay away from the snowman.
Christopher Buffett and Jennifer Drake cut the cake. The evening concluded with the dances.
Restless tonight, cause I wasted the light. Between all these times, I drew a thin line. It's nothing I plan, and not that I can. But you should be mine, across that line. If I traded it all, if I gave it something.
Yeah.
king and queen were crowned, and they were Della McDowell and Jennifer Drake. Congratulations to all the graduates.
I hate the world today. You're so good to me. I know that I can change. Tried to tell you, but you're looking at me like an angel on your face. Innocent and sweet. Yesterday I cried. Must have been relieved to see the softer side.
Concludes our program for tonight. I would like to take this opportunity to wish all the mothers out there a very happy Mother's Day. Thank you for watching. Good night.